สวัสดีค่ะ In this session we are going to learn about the equilibrium constant for acid and base ionization. Let's talk about the previous lesson a little bit. The previous one we learned about the strength of acid and base. And we separate the strong acid from weak acid by how much they ionize in water. Strong acid ionize completely 100%, where the weak acid only partially ionize. And we saw from previous lesson that the weak acid that only partially ionize in water show a reversible reaction and it has equilibrium. So we can get the equilibrium constant for the acid ionization, as well as the equilibrium constant for base ionization as well. Reminder, from the previous chapter, if we have a general chemical equation, A, B as reactant, C, D as product, we can write the equilibrium constant K equal to CD divided by AB concentration or raised by stoichiometry coefficient. In this chapter, we look at the equilibrium of acid ionization in water. So if we represent any weak acid, monoprotic weak acid as HA, this can be any type of acid. We only focus on one proton, and the rest of the formula can be represented by A letter. If HA is in water, so this is acid. It will donate proton to water and become hydronium ion. If you can go back to the very first lesson on this chapter, นะคะ, and it's gonna have the conjugate base remain. Compare this to this equilibrium, so you can get the equilibrium constant expression as product hydronium ion conjugate base and reactant acid. Remember, we do not include the term of pure liquid in our expression for equilibrium constant. So here you get the acid ionization constant as Ka. Again, Ka is equal to concentration of hydronium ion multiplied by concentration of its conjugate base divided by concentration of the acid itself. Remember, all of this value has to be the number at equilibrium state. Right now, we are not doing the calculation just yet. We just look at the term, the equation that relate to this Ka, นะคะ. Strength of acid is depends on how much the concentration of the hydronium ion. So if concentration of hydronium ion increase, it means that this is the stronger acid. So it will make the Ka value increase as well. So we can say that the strength of acid is related to the concentration of hydronium ion in the solution, and the strength of acid is also directly related to the acid ionization constant of that acid. From the first lesson on this chapter, if we don't mind writing the water in the acid dissociation or ionization reaction can be written as HA separate into proton and its conjugate base. So if you write equation like this, your Ka is going to look like this. นะคะ. Just show you this so that if you read from different textbook, you might see this equation. But I would prefer for you to write this kind of equation where you can see that acid donate proton to water. If we look at the basic ionization constant or KB, let's have this equation for the base represented by B. In water, base accept proton from water, so water give hydrogen, so the base will become its conjugate acid has one more proton and the charge is positive, plus hydroxide ion. So in this equation, we get the expression for equilibrium constant as KB, which is equal to conjugate acid concentration multiplied by hydroxide concentration divided by base concentration, all of which are concentration at equilibrium state. So the strength of the base is related to the concentration of hydroxide, and that also relates to the value of KB. This is the table that shows the ionization equilibrium for acid and base, as well as it shows the ionization constant. For acid, it is Ka. For base, it is Kb. And you can see from this slide that the strength of acid increases when the Ka value increases. As well, the base strength increase as the value of Kb increase. Another terms that we can use to represent or to identify the strength of acid or base. On this slide, I just show you the degree of ionization of acid. The degree of ionization is the ratio of the concentration of hydronium ion and its initial concentration of acid. Of course, for any weak acid, is only partially ionized, which means that the concentration of hydronium ion is going to be less than that of the original or initial concentration of acid. So this ratio is going to be less than 1. To make the number into the better look or easy to compare, we change this degree of ionization into percent ionization simply by multiply 100 into the equation above. Ka value would relate to the amount of degree of ionization, because higher degree of ionization means higher concentration of hydronium ion, and that's gonna give higher value of Ka as well. Now let's look back to when we first differentiate between strong acid and weak acid. This is example of monoprotic acid, HA. You can see here that for the strong acid, HA produce H plus and A minus in equal amount. One mole of HA give one mole of proton. So if take it into concentration, let's say 1 molar. 1 molar HA produce 1 molar proton. So here would be 1 divided by 1 multiplied by 100 equal to 100%, which is why in the very first lesson, we separate strong acid from weak acid in terms of 100% ionization. If we look at the weak acid, only few proton is produced, so relatively there is only small amount of this compared to its initial concentration. So supposedly we have 1 molar of acid and we only found 0.05 molar of this proton or hydronium ion. The ratio would be 0.05 divided by 1 multiplied by 100, and that gives 5% ionization. This is just example of the value, นะคะ. So different of the weak acid type would have different percent ionization. Strong acid, 100% ionization. Weak acid, less than 100. And normally, it's a very small number here. Okay, another equilibrium that is quite important in this acid-base solution. We learned from previous lesson that water is a molecule that is amphiprotic. Amphiprotic means it can give and take proton. So if we have two molecules of water, one give proton, another take proton. So we can get this equilibrium. And this is called the self-ionization of water. We can write this equation like this. Water separate into proton and hydroxide ion. This is also a self-ionization of water. So just remove this for now. This equilibrium, we can also write the equilibrium constant, and this time it is Kw. This is represent water. Kw is equal to concentration of product. We don't include concentration of reactant because they are in pure liquid form. So Kw is equal to concentration of hydronium ion multiplied by concentration of hydroxide ion. This is a very important value that you should remember it. At 25 degrees Celsius, the value of Kw is 1.0 times 10 to the minus 14. When you recalculate the concentration of each of these species at 25 degrees Celsius, they're going to be equal for pure water. They're going to be equal, and that is 1 times 10 to the minus 7 molar. Remember the value of Kw and the value of hydronium ion concentration, hydroxide ion concentration in pure water, นะคะ. Okay, when we know that water can have the self-ionization reaction which produce hydronium ion and hydroxide ion. So in every acid-base solution, in aqueous solution, or acid dissolved in water, base dissolved in water. In every solution of aqueous solution, again, we're gonna have some amount of hydronium ion and some amount of hydroxide ion. In acid and base, in aqueous solution, this concentration of the two species are not equal, but we're gonna have some of this and some of that in every aqueous solution of acid and base. The equilibrium constant Kw is the key to calculate how much of this when we have how much of that. Use this equation to calculate the amount of hydronium ion or the amount of hydroxide ion in every acid and base in aqueous solution. Let's have a look at this diagram. Comparison of the amount of hydronium ion and hydroxide ion in neutral solution, in acid solution, and in basic solution. Neutral solution such as water, we've learned already that the amount of hydronium ion equal the amount of hydroxide ion, and that is 1 times 10 to the minus 7 molar. In acidic solution, acid show its strength related to the amount of hydronium ion. So of course, in acidic solution, we're gonna have more of hydronium ion than hydroxide ion. But this is not zero, remember. You're gonna have both species, but we have more hydronium ion, so it is acid. Same thing, if we have a basic solution, doesn't mean that the hydronium ion is zero. We only have hydroxide ion in a more amount compared to hydronium ion. Okay? Let's see. If you are asked to calculate the amount of hydronium ion and hydroxide ion in acid solution, this equation is for strong acid, hydrochloric acid. This is for acetic acid, which is a weak acid. Acid ionization equation is shown like this. Hydrochloric acid donate proton to water, give hydronium ion and chloride ion. Acetic acid, donate proton to water, produce hydronium ion and its conjugate base. If you are asked to calculate amount of hydronium ion, it kind of makes sense because you find out how much is this. You get your answer. From these two equations, you may think of, if you are asked to calculate the amount of hydroxide, you're gonna say zero. But it's not true, because we learned that in aqueous solution, we have this equilibrium of self-ionization of water as well. So in the strong acid system, we have the combination of two reactions going on. So here it is, you get hydroxide ion. In the weak acid system, you have these two equations also happening at the same time. So the amount of hydroxide ion is calculated from self-ionization of water. Now let's see. So if you are asked to calculate the concentration of hydronium ion and hydroxide ion in hydrochloric acid that has concentration equal to 0.0015 molar. This is the ionization reaction of this acid. Acid in water give hydronium ion and its conjugate base. Remember the pattern, nakha? You can do this equation for any acid. Remember, acid donate proton to water and that make hydronium ion. And the rest of the acid is its conjugate base. Don't forget that in this system, we also have the self-ionization of water happening at the same time. So the amount of hydronium ion is calculated from the summation of these two. Strong acid has concentration of 0.0015 molar. Strong acid ionize 100%, which means that it's gonna give 0.15 molar, 0.0015 molar of hydronium ion and 0.0015 molar of chloride ion. How about the self-ionization of water? We know that in pure water, we get this amount of hydronium ion, right? So add these two together, we will get hydronium ion concentration like this. So the amount of hydronium ion is the sum of these two amounts adding together. Hydronium ion concentration is equal to 0.015 plus 1 times 10 to the minus 7. When you add these two together, you're going to get answer approximate to 0.0015 molar anyway, because this is too small compared to this one. Okay, so for a solution of strong acid, if you are asked about how much is the hydronium ion concentration, you can get answer as the equal number to the acid concentration itself. How about hydroxide ion concentration. Is it going to be this value from the self-ionization of water? The answer is no. Why is not? Because from the equilibrium point of view, from the first chapter, if you disturb equilibrium, the equilibrium will shift to regain the equilibrium again, right? Right now, this self-ionization of water is disturbed by increasing the amount of hydronium ion because of this strong acid ionization reaction. So if hydronium ion is increased, equilibrium will shift to the left, right? Equilibrium will shift to the left, which means that hydroxide ion is going to be less than 1 times 10 to the minus 7. How much is it going to be? We know that the constant value of equilibrium constant, this is self-ionization of water, has Kw equal to hydronium ion concentration times hydroxide ion concentration. Right now, we know that we have hydronium ion 0.0015 molar. We can calculate hydroxide ion concentration from this relationship straight away like this. Hydroxide ion is going to be equal to Kw divided by hydronium ion concentration. Take hydronium ion concentration from your answer here. Substitute here. Substitute the value of Kw 1 times 10 to the minus 14. And this is going to be your concentration of the hydroxide. You can see from this slide already that in strong acid, you have a lot of hydronium ion compared to hydroxide ion. This is very high, this is very low, but it doesn't mean that hydroxide ion would be zero in strong acid solution. Bring us back to this diagram, นะคะ. It is proved that in acid solution that has water as a solvent, aqueous solution of acid has more amount of hydronium ion than hydroxide ion. Remember, hydroxide ion is there because of the self-ionization of water. The relationship of Ka, Kb, and Kw can be seen for conjugate acid-base pair. This is again use the basic concept in equilibrium constant value. For a conjugate acid-base pair, let's write the ionization equation for acid. Example here is for acetic acid. Acetic acid in water give hydronium ion and its conjugate base. We can write equilibrium constant, this time it is Ka, equal to hydronium ion, acetate ion, divided by acetic acid. Have a look at ionization equation of base. Take base as the conjugate base of the acid, acetic acid here, acetate ion in water. It is a base, so it takes proton from water, make acetic acid back, and hydroxide ion. This equation has equilibrium constant as Kb, and that equal to product acetic acid, hydroxide ion, and acetate ion. Remember from the first chapter, if we add these two equations together, this is the result. We can cancel the same term on opposite side of the arrow. Acetic acid cancel with acetic acid. Acetate ion cancel with acetate ion. And this is what we have. This is the self-ionization of water, right? So its equilibrium constant gonna be Kw. Because we add these two together, so the Kw is equal to the Ka multiplied by Kb. This is from the first chapter, นะคะ same concept. Adding any equation, the concentration, no, the equilibrium constant is the product of the O constant multiplied together, นะคะ So this is Kw equal to Ka times Kb. And that equal to hydronium ion multiplied by hydroxide ion concentration. Make a note here to yourself that this only work for a pair of conjugate acid and base. This is useful because go back to the table of ionization constant, we can only list Ka of weak acid. We can only list Ka of weak acid. We do not need to list Kb of its conjugate base as well in the same table. That's gonna make a very long table, okay? But we can calculate the Kb for the conjugate base from the value of Ka, like this example here. So if you ask a question, what is Kb of acetate ion? Given that the acid, acetic acid, has Ka equal to 1.5 times 10 to the minus 5, you know that acetate ion is the conjugate base of acetic acid. So the relationship between Ka and Kb is equal to Kw. Calculate Kb, you rearrange equation and substitute all the value in, you get the answer like this. Okay, so here is the summary of this session. We learn about acid and base ionization constant. This has the same pattern as equilibrium constant expression for any reversible reaction. For acid ionization energy, Ka is equal to concentration of hydronium ion multiplied by concentration of conjugate base divided by concentration of the acid itself. Remember, Ka relate to hydronium ion. This number must be the value at equilibrium state. Ka is related to the amount of hydronium ion, which is the strength of acid. So strength of acid is related to Ka. High value of Ka, stronger the acid. Same thing for basic ionization constant Kb. Kb is equal to the conjugate acid of the base multiplied by hydroxide divided by concentration of the base itself. Kb relate to hydroxide ion. Strength of base is also related to the value of Kb. We also learn about water ionization constant Kw. Kw is equal to 1 times 10 to the minus 14. That gives neutral solution has equal amount of hydronium ion and hydroxide ion. For any conjugate acid-base pair, the Ka and Kb multiply to be equal to Kw. And that's it for this video. I see you next time, นะคะ สวัสดีค่ะ